Hello children, good morning. Today we'll be taking up English class, Unit 3, Importance of Language. So here we are talking about the language, because language is the main medium to communicate with the people. See, whatever I am talking, whether it is in Hindi, English or Telugu, if you know, then only you can understand it. Right children? So importance, each and every language is the most important factor in today's life, or the from when the life has emerged on the earth. Every living organism, whether it is a plant, animal, bird or human being, needs some communication to understand what others are saying or what they wanted to tell to us or convey to us. Okay, there are many languages around the world. We ourselves in India also, we have many languages, out of which we use only 18 to 22 languages officially. Okay children, let us take up this lesson. Everyone of you open English textbook, page number 26. Importance of language. As far back in a time as when life began on earth, that means when the life started existing on earth, there has been always one form of communication or other. Always there was only one form or the other to communicate, to convey one message to the other person. Microorganisms, plants and animals all communicate. So we think that animals do not communicate, but actually they communicate by doing sounds or by changing their body forms. A world without communication would be a very confused one. Without telling anything, without doing any action or anything, we cannot tell the other person what we wanted to do or what we wanted to ask them. Right? So, animals communicate using sounds and body language. How do animals communicate? They make sounds or different body languages. When a dog wags its tail, it means it is happy or playful. When the dog is wagging its tail, okay, toka upadam antaru kada, so then that means it's very happy and it is in a mood to play. But if its body becomes rigid or stiff, accompanied by a deep throat growl, it means other thing. The dog has given a warning, and for one's own sake, one must take a heed of it. Then when the dog is very angry, that means it is showing that it is angry and we must just move on from it. So, or else we have to save ourselves, or else the dog may bite us. In the early days, human communication happened through grimaces. That means different facial expressions, like doing. These are different kinds of expression they used to do in the previous generations. Okay. Gestures. Gestures means the action which is done by the hands or legs. We'll be telling, right? Without telling a word from our mouth, if we are just moving our hand, showing that or this, that means the other person can understand if we have that gesture knowledge. And tones. Tones means making different kinds of sounds. Okay? Variations in different kinds of sounds made with the hands or legs or with our mouth. Different sounds. Early man used pictures for communicating. Early man, when the present generation, when the early man came into the existence, he was like looking like a monkey, right, like an ape. So when he started living on the earth, archaeology, they were using some pictures. Like example, if it is a biscuit, example I'm telling you, this is a biscuit, okay, and he's showing one man or a one dog. See, I don't know to draw a dog, even though I'm showing you. I think this is a dog only. So if it's showing biscuit and dog, that means the dog have eaten the biscuit or put the biscuit to the dog, or this biscuit belongs to dog. Okay, they used to draw some pictures to give the communication, to convey the message to the other person. Archaeologists have found many cave paintings with cattle and weapons as a subject matter. So the people who do research on history, ancient history, are known as archaeologists. They have found many paintings in the caves, okay, in the olden caves. That means that those paintings and the carvings the sculptures have been designed by the early people who used to live when the earth originated. paintings can be considered as man's first attempt to create and evolve a language. That means that shows that man was trying to communicate by drawing with things or caving on, making these sculptures on the cave walls. Now, Egyptians' hieroglyphics is an elevated form of early communication. Now, Egyptian people have means designating or reflecting to a pictorial script. That means they have written something. Okay, Egyptians. That thing was also a kind of communication to convey the message to the people. So that was the elevated sign. That means from there it has rosed. Rosed means being coming under a force, so that the other people also learn to communicate in particular form, which involved using pictures. But this process was long and tedious. Tedious means which was very long process and which have taken much and much time to come into the force. Necessity is indeed the mother of invention. See, whatever we need, that is the mother of invention. Which if the things we are needing, if we are getting the things which we need, with that many things we can create or design. So that is only known as necessity is mother of invention. See, if you are hungry, you need food, right children? So if you wanted to survive, you eat food. You ask to your mom, or your mom, by seeing you, she can understand our mind and she can understand our condition. She provides us without you telling any word. By seeing your body language only, she provides you. Right. So for an example I am giving you, that is known as a necessity is a mother of invention. That doesn't mean that your mother is inventing anything. I am just giving you an example. As the different forms of communication which were used since the beginning of time fell short in the effectiveness, something better had to be put in their place. So every time everyone was forcing, all the people were trying to communicate with the different things, with the pictures or with the drawings and with the paintings and all, but some or the other they were lagging. Some people were able to understand, some people were not able to understand. So all the people came in front and they explored their ideas, explored their brain to make it something better, so that every human being understand what these guys are planning or what other guy wanted to tell them. So however, this evolution did not happen in one day. It took a long time for language to come to its present form. So whatever they decided, that did not happen very soon. It has taken long and long time so that the language came into the force. Today I am speaking in English with you all. You can understand, because this language is taught you all from your kindergarten school only, from your play school, from your home only. Before you join the school, you were taught little bit of English, where you can understand small words. Then you gradually learn what we are explaining it today. Am I right, children? So if it is for this reason of having better skills and the ability to communicate by using a language, that man has been elevated above other life forms. So this was the ability to convey something to the other person. Language, one must accept, is a bridge of communication. Language is a bridge of communication. See, if you wanted to tell anything, you have to use a language, whether it is your mother tongue or whether if you are not perfect with that language, what you do? See, let us take an example of a little baby who does not know how to speak. What he'll do? He try to murmur the words, right? By stammering only, he will murmur the words. He try to pronounce, or he'll do such kind of signs, so that we can understand that this guy wants some or the other thing to play or to eat. Rather than that, the small children doesn't do anything. They'll play or they'll make noise, or they wanted to eat something, or they'll go back to the sleep. So when an idea in one person's mind is transferred to the mind of another, we can say communication has happened between them. So when I am talking to one girl or one of you guys, that means I am telling something. That means this is a communication where I am conveying a message to you. Okay, where you are able to understand, that is known as the communication. If you are not able to understand, your mind is somewhere that I am going on talking, then there is no use of it, right? So if A says something, something and we understand something else, that is not effective communication. If one person is saying something and the other person is understanding something other thing, there is no effectiveness. There is no use of using that kind of a language. For effective communication to happen, there must be a common understanding. So when something has to take place, some good communication has to take place, good understanding has to take place, both the person, both the parties have to have the common understanding on that particular thing. Or else you will fight, I will fight. I will say one thing, you will understand another thing. Okay children, that is known as an understanding. Then, for instance, a four-legged piece of furniture that is used for sitting is named a chair. Okay, the four-legged, our chair have four legs, right? That we have kept it, we have named it as a chair. As not only you or not only me, all over the world call it chair only. We cannot call it as a dog because dog also have four legs, camel also have four legs. Because it's a non-living thing and we have given it a particular name as chair. Now if you call it as a goat or a dog or any other animal, no one can understand it. Before inventing that thing or after invention, we have to name it definitely. Or else we will be getting confusion. You will be calling something other to it, I will be calling something other to it. So understanding is important, not only language, understanding of that language is also important, equally important. So for instance, a four-legged piece of furniture that is used for sitting is named a chair. Under universal agreement, that means all the people that at that time, all the people agreed to name it as a chair. If suddenly somebody wants to call it a goat, it would lead to much confusion and chaos, right? Someone suddenly called, no, it is not a chair, it is a goat, then it will lead to a confusion. Because see, when well-educated people are coming and telling this is not this, this is, because that animals also have four legs and this thing also have four legs, this is not that and this is this. So it will give confusion and chaos. Chaos means getting into a quarrel and getting into an arguments. Such similar arguments hold good for everything that exists. Otherwise, we would be living in a confusion and misunderstanding. So this understanding has to be kept compulsory or else it will be completely misunderstanding. People would be just talking but nobody would be communicating. Because if understanding is not there, everyone will be just talking, not communicating. Communicating is what I said. The other person have to understand what the first person is telling. That is known as a communication. If the other person is not understanding, then it will be like only that guy is talking but this guy is not understanding. So in the modern world, we use English. Present world, what we do as a medium language to convey our message, we use English only, right children? As a common language of communication. The English language spread across the world as a result of British colonialism. That means British policy has stated that English has to be spoken all over the world and most of the people in the world understand English. This has brought most parts of the world under a common umbrella. That means most part of the world, that means 75%, 85% of the world have come into one umbrella. That means in the one understanding, it has eased many processes and has led to a better understanding of ideas, concepts on an international level. Everyone understood that English has to be kept as an official language where whatever we think and communicate with the people, it has to be written or spoken in English so that each and everyone can understand what we are talking about or what we are signing about, what we are going to do about. In India, let's talk about India now. In India, there are 22 major languages written in 13 different scripts. There are 22 major languages which are written in 13 different scripts. Okay, there is a script, right? This is written in English, right children? I, M, P, O, R. This alphabet is English alphabet. So it is an English script. So this thing is written in English. Now whatever the things we are writing, if we write in the same alphabetical order, alphabet, that is known as English script. If we are writing something in Hindi, that is known as Hindi script. So about there are 22 languages and they are written in only 13 scripts with over 720 dialects. Dialects means a particular form of a language. Okay, there is, see, you may also speak Hindi, I may also speak Hindi, some other also speak Hindi. But the dialect, that means the way we use the language may differ from one regional person to other regional person. The official Indian languages are Hindi, because approximately more than half of the Indians can understand Hindi. About 420 million speakers, okay, Hindi, they can understand. And English, which is also widely spoken. In India, the official languages are Hindi and English. So children, this one I will be explaining you in the next video.